Welcome to today's program. I'm Rev John Okachi, and happy Independence Day. I want to especially congratulate all Nigerians, both home and abroad, for in another October 1st since 1960. And I want to especially pray for all the Nigerians who are here, both home and abroad, as well, that our good God will continue to keep this country in peace, in unity, in progress, and in prosperity. Happy celebration once more. Guess what? I see you celebrating in this month. This is the month of independence. It is your month of liberty as well. Believe me, this is the month Nigerians experience total freedom from bondage and celebrate. You can see it right now as your month of liberty and celebration. I want to say to you that everything in this month of October, everything holding you from celebrating will leave you alone. And as they leave you alone, celebration will be your portion. I see you celebrating in this month. And I want to say to you that I release you in the name of the Lord Jesus to celebrate in this month. Celebrate in this month. No power will be able to hold you to celebrate in this month. I usher you into celebration. Beginning from today, 1st of October, 2020, I usher you into celebration. In every of your endeavor, I usher you into celebration. In your marriage, I usher you into celebration. In your business, in your finance, in everything that you are doing, I usher you in the name of the Lord Jesus into celebration. Celebration is your portion. Can I hear you say amen? I want you to see in Genesis chapter 15, verse 13, Bible should tell Abraham in that place. He said, as far as you can see, that I have given unto you. I want you to see celebration. Like I'm saying to you that I see you celebrating. I see you celebrating. And I want you to join me to see yourself celebrating. I see you celebrating because it's the month of independence. You as well can see yourself. See the month of independence as your month of freedom from every bondage to celebrate. In this month, by the power of the Holy Ghost, you are released to celebrate. You are being released to celebrate. See yourself being free to celebrate. You celebrate in your finance. You celebrate in your marriage. You celebrate in everything you do in the name of the Lord Jesus. You have to see by yourself. Because Abraham had to see his own by himself. God said to him, as far as you can see, that I have given unto you. As far as you can see, that land I have given unto you. So you have to see. Life is not all about God. You have to see. If it's all about God, God would have just done it for Abraham. But he said to Abraham, you see. As long as you see, as far as you can see, that I have given unto you. If you see celebration, the word of God will deliver it into your hand. If you see celebration, God will deliver it into your hand. See the month of October as your month of celebration. As you see, no power will be able to withhold you. As I have said to you, every power holding you back from celebration is leaving you alone, just alone to celebrate. As you believe in God's word and see yourself celebration, celebration will not depart from you. Celebration will not lack in your life. Celebration will not cease in your life. Both you and your family will celebrate in all areas of your life. God bless you. In the name of the Lord Jesus. I want to especially thank all Nigerians who, in spite of the challenges in this country, they still see the need to be doing something with their hand instead of doing otherwise. I want to pray for you that the good God whom we serve will remember you. Bible tells us that Peter, after Jesus has asked him to give him his boat, and he delivered the boat into Jesus to you, Peter thought that Jesus would not remember him because he used the boat for so long. But after Jesus was through, he said to Peter, launch into the deep again. So Jesus remembered Peter. The God who remembered those who walk with their hand will remember you and promote you. I want to also encourage all those Nigerians, both home and abroad, most especially those who are living here in the country, who, in spite of the darkness that the leadership style of many of our leaders keep showing us, you cannot see light. Every day we keep seeing darkness, we keep seeing hopelessness. But in spite of this darkness that the leadership style of many of our leaders keep showing us, you still see the need to have hope in this country. I love it for you. I give it to you. That's wonderful of you. When everything looks hopeless, you keep seeing hope in the country. You keep seeing a new Nigeria. You keep seeing a beautiful Nigeria. You keep seeing and enjoying Nigeria. As you keep having this hope, I can also tell you that the God who remember those who have hope in life will remember his children in this land. And this country, once in a time, will become a country that we are all will be proud of in this country. I also want to talk to those who think that it's by wickedness that they must make it in life. No. That's not the way to function. That's not the way to think. There is a way to function. You cannot make it that way. That's not God's giving way. God's giving way to make it in life is the life that he gives to you. When God gives you life, he has given you an opportunity to make it in life. When God gives you help, he has given you an opportunity to make it in life. God give you hand, God give you leg. That's all the ability that God has given to you to make it. God's giving way to make it is the life and the hand that God has given to you. Ritual, making it through thinking of ritual is not the God's giving way to make it. Making it, thinking of making it through kidnapping is not the God's giving way to make it. Thinking of making it through killing your mother or killing your father or killing any of your loved one or your wife or your child, whatever it is, thinking of making it through killing your friend, through deceiving yourself, through doing one thing or the other, is not the way to make it. I want to beg all our leaders who think that they can also make it through investment or public fund. That's not the way to make it. If you think that way, you are not thinking right. Anything you do that is not to the benefit of your neighbor is not the best way. You make it at the expense of your neighbor, and then you are happy and your neighbor is crying. It's not God's way. The Bible says, whatsoever a man sows, so shall he reap. The Bible says there is time for everything. Look at God's word and make a change. I want to encourage us at this time to make a change. Stop the killing. Stop the thinking first, because it all begins from our thinking. Stop the kidnapping. Stop the ritual. Stop the robbery. Stop the investment of the government fund to make it. Stop all of the evil ways that you think that you can make it through. That's not the way. I want to encourage all Nigerians at this time that God of hope is there for us. And once again, he's going to give us hope. He's the one that gave hope in the Bible days. The Bible told us as I ran up here that in Samaria, it was so dark for the people of Israel. But they keep looking unto God, that their God one day will remember them. The Bible says, as they keep looking unto God to change the situation of Samaria. It was so high that one time the Bible told us that even two women were eating their children. One said to the other one, today let's eat my son. Today tomorrow we eat your son. It happened in Bible day that they eat their son. It was so terrible. Even as it is today, although nobody has eaten his son in this country, but it's darkness. But the people of Samaria keep having hope. And finally, as they keep having hope, one day, God used a common thing to change the situation of Samaria. The Bible told us that how that the leprosy men were lepers, three lepers were in the bush, where they have exempted them, isolated them, because leprosy cannot mingle with the public. And see, the public have not had food to eat. How can they give to the lepers? The food, the lepers do not eat. And I talk to themselves, how can we eat? If we remain here in the bush, we will die. If we go to the enemy's camp, we will die. That was all orchestrated by God. It was God who planted that idea. That let us know that it is God who walketh in our boat to do of his good pleasure. So the Bible says, the Bible told us how these men thought that if we remain here, we die. But if we go to the enemy camp, we die. So let's go. If we die in the enemy camp, it's better. The Bible says they start going to the enemy's camp, the Assyrian camp, where there is abundant food. The Bible says, while they were going, God make the sound of their leg to be like the sound of multitude of soldiers. And when the Assyrian heard the sound of their leg, the Bible says they ran away. And then these three leprosy men went to their camp and they found more than enough. As they ate, they brought the news to the entire Samaria. So overnight, God changed the story of Samaria. And the Bible has said to us in Proverbs chapter 15, verse 4, whatsoever is written before now is written for our learning. So that portion of the scripture is written for our learning. It said that we, through patience of the scripture, every Nigerian, I want to beg you to have patience of the scripture. Just through patience and hope of the scripture, through patience and encouragement of the scripture. I know everything in the country, nothing is giving us patience, nothing is giving us hope, but the word of God should give you patience today. The word of God should give you hope today. As a Samaritan, have patience and hope. Finally, God turned the story of Samaria into a testimony. One day, the God of hope, the God of remembrance, the God of testimony. We remember this country, we remember us with our hope, we remember all with testimony, and everything in this country we turn into a testimony. I pray for all of us today that God will bless us, God will bless Nigeria, and as God turned this country into hope, it shall be well with us. Once again, the Bible says, as the Lord turned again the captivity of Zion, they were like them that dream. It shall be so for Nigeria. Can I hear you say amen? As I hope to see you next time on this channel for more inspiration, for more word of hope, and for more story of testimony. God bless you.